This is Chicago's very own WGN Morning News at 7.
Also this morning, the folks from Gene and Georgetti joining us with some patriotic party ideas.
And the presidents are back with us coming up next. First, we're firing up the grill and getting some Independence Day party ideas from Gene and Georgetti.
Here. It is quite the 4th of July party, let me tell you, Anna. So we've got the crew from Gene and Georgetti's out here. Michelle Durpetti is going to tell us how to really celebrate big for this 4th of July holiday,
right? Yeah, you know, for us, it's all about taking comfort foods and things that we love and bringing family together and just celebrating the day. So we recently opened up a new location in Rosemont. It's the first time we've opened a second location in 74 years. That's amazing. Our head chef with us today. Yeah, it's real exciting.
Yeah.
We have our head chef, Luis, with us today, who took some really cool things, 4th of July sort of staples, and has a little bit of a twist.
And I brought Demetrius out here with me because There's no way I can eat all of this on my own.
I'm just here to make sure this food is up to code, okay?
Absolutely. We appreciate the quality control. So over here we have some corn on the cob. You'll see it's just with a little bit of twist. We have sour cream and a queso añejo on that on a stick, so super easy to eat, right? Mm-hmm. Right in front of that, we've got steak kebabs. There's a teriyaki glaze on that. Again, steak kebabs are something you see all the time. Teriyaki glaze just makes it a little bit different. Of course, staples for 4th of July are any great barbecue. Barbecue chicken wings, barbecued ribs.
You're going to save these for me.
I'll save this entire platter. That's just for you. Yeah, do not disturb right there.
So these are all the traditional things.
Yeah.
We're trying to do a little bit of a twist on some other things. You've got like a pasta salad.
Absolutely.
You've got these awesome cupcakes here.
Yeah, and we've got this great, so the cupcakes are from Elysia Root Cakes, along with the cake that you see a little bit of fireworks on there. Just something fun to have. These cupcakes are a great little twist. They're red velvet with the red, white, and blue, so we get that. We've got this beautiful pasta salad that we brought with us. Again, a little bit of a twist. And this Romanesco salad, which you'll see over here to my left.
Wow. Oh, what is in this?
So this is actually a family member of the cauliflower, and it's just got a lot of texture. There's crunch in there.
Yep, there's a little bit of everything in there.
So there's radishes. There's a little bit of everything. It's just great. And it's good color, and it tastes great. It's great with
all of
the ribs and that. Yeah. So another great thing to have, right, which you
were
holding.
Sounds like vegetables. Nah.
Well, it's good with the ribs. It'll go.
Yeah.
You got to have some green, right? Another really important thing at a great barbecue is beverages, right?
Yeah.
So, of course, like something that's really cute. Oh, would you guys like some while we're standing here, by the way?
I would love some. Would you like to try one?
You have yours already? Let's try this one. So this
one.
Is
this me?
Yes, this is you. So this is a lemon lavender honey mint. It's with lemon sorbet. Pretty good, right?
Yeah.
This one that you have on camera is a watermelon lemonade. It's really good. If we keep moving along, you'll see, like, punch bowls are a great decor item.
Yeah, and the thing that I like about what you guys are doing out here is that you really have it decorated so nice.
And it's
everything looks so fancy.
Two great things you got to have when you do barbecue. Cotton candy, right? And the other thing, Spin Spun is with us here today. We love it. The other thing you really need in a segment for a great 4th of July barbecue is the confetti cannon.
Yeah.
Where's the confetti cannon?
All right.
We're ready now.
That's a party. I want some of that cotton candy, too,
it's,
by the way. Can you say
awesome.
It's, what, 100 calories?
100 calories. It's all natural, so no artificial color, no artificial flavor. It's really good. Spin Spun is a phenomenal company.
Just because I like you, Dean.
Spin Spun. Organic,
and less than 100 calories. And the reason it's white is because there's no artificial color, there's no artificial flavor. It's complete. It's kosher. Most of their flavors are gluten-free. It is. It's awesome. Yeah.
Well, you have put together quite a party for us. Thank you so much.
You're so welcome.
Good luck on your opening, July 22nd.
Yes.
Yeah. See you there.
Thanks.
All right. We'll be right back, everybody, with the news at 9.
Grandma, you know that? That's all good enough.
Cheers.
Oh, that was awesome.
Hey, we're starting the party already, and what better way to kick it off than with one of Chicago's best steakhouses? The folks from Gene and Georgetti are outside with a 4th of July party, and we'll join them right after the break.
Come on, let your colors burst. Make them go. You're gonna leave them calling. After a hurricane comes a rainbow. Maybe a reason why all the doors are closed. So you could open one that leads you to the perfect road.
Hey, let's check in with Mike and Patrick. Hey, guys.
Larry, good to hear from you again. I'm out here with Chef Luis from Gene and Georgetti. Now, you're putting some chicken on over there. Correct?
I am, man.
High heat, just medium heat. What are we doing over here?
Well, we're barbecuing. We have barbecue chicken.
Yeah.
We marinated overnight with some beer and some spices.
What's the minimum you can marinate something for? You hear varying instructions. Some people say marinate for an hour, marinate it overnight. Is there a certain point you hit where it's like, all right, enough marinating?
You know, overnight is good.
Yeah.
It depends on the size of the meat. Chicken overnight should be fine.
I noticed something with your kebabs here. You didn't space out the entire stick. You only really put the meat and vegetables on one end, and you leave the skewer hanging off. Why do you do that?
Well, a quick tip, when you're using wooden skewers,
yeah.
What I did here is I just put them to the side of the grill so the stick doesn't burn.
Yeah. And does it get less hot? Is it easier for you to turn over that way, too?
You can say that.
Yeah, all right. I'm going to say it.
Okay.
Excellent. Any other tips, basic tips that people should look out for today when they're firing up their grill today or tomorrow?
Well, I think you should clean your grill in between grillings.
Yeah.
Because all of the stuff that burns on it just sticks to the next clean stuff.
All right. Chef Luis, thanks so much.
Thank you.
I'll tell you what, if there's one guy here besides Paul Conrad who knows about fashion, it's Mike Toomey. So thank the Lord that he is over there talking about some 4th of July fashions for us.
I've been waiting all week for this, Pat. We're outside celebrating Independence Day with Michelle Durpetti. She's from the famed Gene and Georgetti restaurant, The Estate. The newest Gene and Georgetti property.
Yes.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Michelle,
how are
good
you?
To see you.
You too.
We have a special guest with us too.
We
have Peach Carr.
Well, so we're talking about barbecue party trends, food, everything today. So you want to have the right barbecue look when you go to a party. So we were fortunate enough today, courtesy of Tracy Tarantino, to have Peach Carr with us.
Who, of Project Runway
fame.
Yes,
season 8. Absolutely. And a beloved Chicago designer. And she created these one-of-a-kind purses and looks for us today. So women kind of know how to be festive and patriotic at a barbecue. Peach, would you like to take us through the looks?
I like the red lobster one. Is nice.
Thank you. The lobsters are new for me. I woke up in the middle of the night and said lobsters and got up and sketched it and turned it into some fabric, and I'm using it on my bags. And my sense of humor comes out throughout my collection. And these are all little red, white, and blue looks that are made all in Chicago by women. I'm a Chicago native, so I believe in keeping everything here. The bags are all made by myself. They're all hand-painted. And these clothes go in the washing machine, which means if you accidentally jump in the pool,
yeah,
or get caught in a water balloon fight on the 4th of July,
the
or
bag
a little barbecue
does not get
sauce.
Destroyed.
Yeah.
It's perfect.
No, in fact, if you get the barbecue sauce on it, jump in the pool. See how that works.
There you go.
This is bothering me. These two have to switch bags, don't you think? The lady with the lobster dress.
Oh, you never match. Oh no.
That's
no, never match. No, never match.
I was all about the coordination.
It was a good try. You gotta give him credit for trying.
I thought I was catching an error.
Just you're okay, but in women don't like to match. Men need to match. They gotta have that coordination.
Right.
Girls like to mix it up a little bit.
All right, well, let's look at some of these party table settings.
Absolutely.
What do we have?
Earlier today, we talked a little bit about food. We talked about these beautiful cakes and cupcakes from Alicia Root. Something I didn't talk about were these beautiful, adorable little arrangements, courtesy of my friend Derek Taylor at Taylor & Company Events. The great thing about these little arrangements, the roses, you see the mums, the hydrangea, all something you can get at the store. So the great thing about these arrangements is you can make something like this yourself. And when you make them, when you bunch them together, if you use a rubber band before you put them into this little vessel, they'll stay together better, so, and they stay longer, and it's just easier way to arrange. It's a little tip from a florist. The other great tip I can give you is to soak your hydrangea overnight in water. These are hydrangea, this blue flower right here. They won't wilt outside. So sometimes when you're in the heat like this, they get a little withery.
Sure.
So that's basically our floral tips. And you know, we're throwing a big party today. One of the greatest things you bring, courtesy of automated lighting design, is a confetti cannon to a party, right?
Oh, absolutely.
I think we have it. I think we got it. So.
And where? Tell us more about the party.
party, where will it be?
So, well, we're just bringing the party to you today. So, in addition to the confetti cannon, we brought face painting. We have MJ over here painting faces. All of the children you see here today.
Fun for the whole family.
Yeah, they're all family members of our Rosemont staff. So, if you come over here, it's so fun. You can see everyone's getting their faces painted. Spin Spun is a cotton candy company we have with us, so we really wanted the kids to have a good time today. They can do special events, weddings, you name it. All of the cotton candy is organic. No artificial color, flavor, and only about 100 calories a pop. So between our face painting, between our cotton candy, we've got some great cocktails. This party you can bring anywhere. You asked where the party was?
Yep,
you can bring it anywhere you need it to be.
To you.
Absolutely.
And the organic cotton candy enough to put it over the top.
Yeah, absolutely. All courtesy of Gene and Georgetti, of course, because we know how to throw a party.
Oh, it's so cool. Thank you, Michelle.
You're very welcome.
We're going to go back around town to Anna. Hey, Anna.